Good morning, dear students. How are you all? Hope all are fine. We are going to see now, students, 1.7 lesson, Paramvir Chakra Ahiros. Paramvir Chakra Ahiros. Standard 6th, lesson number 1.7, Paramvir Chakra Ahiros. Let us read about him. You may have heard about legendary heroes of the past and their extraordinary acts of bravery. But even today, many brave soldiers of our country sacrifice their own lives for the safety. Their brave deeds are honored by bestowing military decorations on them. Paramvir Chakra is India's highest military decoration. It is awarded for the most conspicuous bravery or same daring or preeminent act of valor or self-sacrifice in the presence of enemy, whether on land or at sea or in the air. So, dear students, we are going to see about Paramvir Chakra. We may have about great heroes, okay, great legendary heroes in the past, about their extraordinary work which we did, about their braveness, okay. So many soldiers of our country sacrifice their lives for our country, for our safety. So their best deeds or their brave deeds are honored by military decorations. So this is the Paramvir Chakra, India's high military military decoration. Okay, he is awarded most conspicuous bravery or some daring preeminent act. Okay, so he is awarded for it. He was a very brave person in the presence of the enemy, or he can fight on the land, sea or in the air also. That much brave he is. So the Paramvir Chakra is a very rare honor. So far it has been awarded only 21 times. 14 of these awards were given posthumously. Okay, so we are going to see about him now. Here is a medal which is given for the Paramvir Chakra. The medal itself is very simple in appearance. It is made of bronze, okay, bronze metal, and it's fitted with swivel mounting and has a plain purple ribbon. On the observe, it has the Indian national emblem at the center, surrounded by four replicas of India's Indra's Vajra. On the reverse, the words Paramvir Chakra are engraved in Hindi and English, with two lotus flowers in between. So this is a medal which has got a national emblem, okay, a national emblem with two lotus flowers. Okay, there are two lotus flowers. The Paramvir Chakra medal was organized by Savitribai Kanolkar. She was a European lady who married Vikram Kanolkar, an Indian army officer. Savitribai loved India and took Indian citizenship. She spoke Marathi, Sanskrit, Hindi fluently and had studied Indian arts and traditional in depth. So this lady, Savitribai Kanolkar, was a European lady, okay, who got married with Vikram Kanolkar. He is an Indian army officer. So she made this medal, okay. She took the Indian citizenships. She spoke Marathi, Sanskrit fluently with the people, and she loved India. She worked for the India. Indira's Vajra or Thunderbolt is supposed to be a matchless weapon, but what makes the weapon invincible is the supreme sacrifice of the sage Dandichi. So this Indira's Vajra or Thunderbolt is supposed to be a matchless weapon, okay. So you know what are the weapons, but what makes the weapon invincible is the supreme sacrifice of the sage Dandichi. According to the legend, thousands of years ago, a demon had stolen all the water in the world. Innocent people were suffering and dying without water. This demon could not be defeated by any ordinary weapon made of ordinary material like wood, metal, etc. Something extraordinary was required. It was learned that the sage Dandichi had bones of such extraordinary power. But how could one ask the bones of living man? Sage Dandiji was a noble person. He himself laid down his life and gave his own bones to help the people. Indravarja, Indra's weapons of thunderbolts, was fashioned from these bones, and their demon was defeated. So 1,000 years ago, a demon had stolen the water in the world. So people were dying, people were without water. This demon could not be defeated. That means he was not be defeated by any other weapon. So this sage, or this person, okay, this person whose name was Vikram Chakra, sorry, whose name was, okay, this sage Dandiji was a noble person, okay, he was a very great person. He himself laid his life, okay, he gave his bones, he fought for the people, okay, and he was fashioned from these bones, and demon was defeated. So he gave his bones, he gave his life for the sake of people, and then with his bones was demon defeated. Just as the Indravarjas derived power from sage Dandiji bones, the Indian military derives its strength and power from the sacrifice of the bravest of the brave, the Paramvir Chakra. So just as the Indian Indravarja derived power from the sage, okay, Dandiji bones, the Indian military derives its strength and power from the sacrifice of the bravest of the braver, okay, the Paramvir Chakra. So like Indravarja derived the strength from that Dandiji bones, same like this Paramvir Chakra takes the soldiers take the power and strength and the model from whom? From this Paramvir Chakra. Flying officer Nirmaljit Singh Sekhan. Okay, so on the 14th of December 1971, Srinagar airfield was attacked by a wave of 66 enemy Sabre aircraft. Flying officer Nirmaljit Singh Sekhan was on readiness duty at that time. He could not take the immediately because of clouds of dust raised by another aircraft. By the time the runway was clear, the enemy aircraft was overheard. So on this date, 14th of December 1971, Srinagar airfield, now Srinagar is in Kashmir, airfield was attacked by a wave of 6 enemy Sabre aircraft. So this Srinagar was attacked by the enemy. Flying officer Nirmaljit Singh Sekhan was on readiness duty at that time. So this flying officer Nirmaljit Singh was on the duty. He could not take off immediately because of clouds of dust raised by another aircraft. Okay, so he was not able to do anything. Why? Because of the clouds which was raised. By that time, runway was clear, the enemy aircraft was overhead. So by the time it was when the clouds went, he saw that the enemies were disappeared. They were flying now, flying and attacking the airfield with bombs. Even then, flying officer Sekhan took off in his Nach fighter the moment he could. He began to combat the powerful Sabre jet aircraft of the enemy. He damaged two of them. So when bombing and everything was going on, were in the air. Okay, they were fighting in the air with the enemy. So this, he began to combat the powerful Sabre jet aircraft of the enemy. He damaged two of them. So he injured two of the enemies. His fight with the attacking aircraft now continued at treetop high. At last, the enemy aircraft fled from the scene of battle. The airfield and the town of Srinagar were saved. So because of this man, the aircraft, okay, and the Srinagar was saved from the whom? From enemy. The airfield and the town of Srinagar were saved, but alas, flying officer Shekhan's aircraft too crashed and he was killed. So he went to save the people and he gave up his life. Flying officer Shekhan displayed great flying skill and determination in the face of certain death. He showed unmatched heroism above and beyond the call of duty. Salute the to the bravest of the brave, flying officer Nirmaljit Singh Shekhan. So this Nirmaljit Shekhan was a good in air, at the weather on land, sea or in the air to fight. Okay, so this Paramvir Singh, okay, this Paramvir Chakra or this Nirmaljit Singh Shekhan did a bravest work for the country, for saving the people. He saved the airfield and the Srinagar. So dear friend, this is a very inspiring story about this fellow who gave up his life for our country. Let us take his example and be like him. So dear students, you will read this whole lesson and go through this lesson and take the good example from this lesson.